Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's practice drawing sp2 hybridized atoms. Now when you draw sp2 hybridized atoms, we need to focus and keep in mind upon our axes. So we're going to establish axes. This is a lot of people use these exact same orientations. We'll have a y-axis that is horizontal left to right. Well, our z-axis will be vertical within the writing surface, and the x-axis will be either oriented coming out of the writing surface or poking back into the writing surface. So, sp2 hybridized atoms. Let's just go ahead and take our s and two p's. That'll give us three sp2 hybrids, plus a leftover. Now we're labeling our axes. We're going to have leftover, in this case, the pz orbital. And that means our sp2 hybrids are going to occupy the yz plane. Why the yz? Well, because we use the px and the py to make these hybrids. So we have to keep track of these axes. What would this look like? Well, let's draw an atom. There's our dot. And around this atom, within the xy plane, are going to be our three hybrid orbitals coming off of that atom. And these hybrids, remember, this is a trigonal planar center. So these hybrids are going to be separated by, where can I draw this, about 120 degrees, as if this were flat in the plane. And then poking perpendicular to this plane is our pz orbital. And I think if you're having trouble seeing this picture, I think it'll be more clear when we add the xy plane. So that is, it's a terrible xy. That is our xy plane. And I've tried to draw our hybrids, and I'll put a star at the end of our hybrids, as if they're sitting in the xy plane. The pz then is perpendicular to it. So can we draw a molecule that looks like this? Yes, we can. This is borane. Borane has three attached atoms, no lone pairs on the boron, and so this is an sp2 center, and we could draw borane just like this picture to the left, and our hybrid orbitals are making these BH bonds. We'll talk about bonding more later, and here is our picture of borane, and borane has a vacant pz orbital. Now, let's try this again, and let's try using different orbitals. So we can do sp2. We don't have to use the px. What if we instead use the py and the pz? We're still going to get three sp2 hybrids. We're going to have a leftover p orbital. In this case, it's going to be the px, and so we'll use the yz plane instead for our hybrids. So the yz plane is the writing surface, and so we'll get something like this. Where is the px? The px is both poking out of, above, the plane of the writing surface and going back in. So this is what this atom would look like with these particular atomic orbitals used to make the hybrids. How would this look like on borane? Something like this. We'll just basically redraw the same picture, but we'll put a boron and hydrogens in there. And here is our vacant p orbital. It's now the px orientation. So when we draw sp2 hybrid atoms, we have to be very careful of our axes and keep track of which p orbitals we're using, which correspond to the different axes.